thing to see that youth. The youth that they have and the ears, the qualities they had listening to their elders. I want to thank them for that. If they can hear me in the background, let me hear you, CM. I'm rolling the floor over to Sacred Water. Haida, Seattle, Native Bridges. You are on deck, Haida, Seattle. OCM Sacred Water.
Dear friends and relatives, it's a good day to be here. We're Sacred Water.
Oh, Sam. That first song that we came in with was called Warrior Paddle. even though it's a warrior paddle, you know, we back in the day, the warriors used to lead that canoe in just in case and just to keep our women protected. And this next song we're going to share with you is a blessing song called For the Changes. I just can see them.
Aho, good morning, Tribal Journeys. Thanking the Creator for another day, another beautiful day on Mother Earth. I'd like to thank each and every one of you for being here at this time. Like my cousin said, we're a Sacred Water Canoe family. Most of us reside in Kitsap County, but we have a lot of family that travels to be with us. We're fortunate to to represent many different nations, many different tribes, many different teachings. That's what makes sacred water who we are. We stand proud and we stand for the people. That's our main focus, is coastal healing. When we sing with our hearts, and we sing with each and every one of you in our hearts and in our minds, with no egos. An elder once taught me, a dear elder that has passed away just recently, to live like that, to be like that once again. Each and every one of us, each and every one of us, Indian people walking this earth without that hate in our hearts, without that backstabbing mentality. Loving each and every one of ourselves, loving each and every one of you, and respecting the way of your families. Knowing that each and every one of us have different ways, we have different teachings, and we respect all of that. We're a young Canoe family. This is our second year. We are real excited to come into Squaxin Islands territory, to pull in Squaxin Islands waters. This is where we began our journey last year, to Swinomish. And we've always been close. I've always felt close to the people from here, from Squaxin Island. Always had a lot of respect for them and a lot of love for them. And I'm thankful to be here today. I'm thankful for the ones that gave up their lives, that went through that pain, that suffering, went through them boarding schools of being raped, having their culture stripped from them, having their minds erased, trying to take who we are away, trying to kill our spirits. I will never forget that. I will never forget the pain and the suffering that my grandfathers, my grandmothers went through, the pain and the suffering that my mom and dad went through. That's why we stand here today. That's why we stand here in a good way, loving each and every one of you from my heart. I just wanted to share that at this time, give you an idea of who Sacred Water is. We're not from one tribe, we're not from one res. We have many here, and we're happy to be able to come here and share our lives, share our spirits, share our prayers with each and every one of you today. We would just like to share some songs today. We don't want to take up too much floor time. We know there's families that are eager to get up here and eager to honor these people here from Squaxin. So I'm real thankful today. I'm real thankful to the Creator and to our grandmother. Aho! Oh. That song was called For Mother Earth. This next song we'd like to share is Moving Waters. Ahu.
And the next song that we would like to share with you today is called One Speed, composed by myself, the Mahto. And it's a paddle song, and it's brand new. It came to me a couple months ago, and I shared it with my auntie Jessie Okaili, the Mahto, a lot, and she really likes it. And she showed her niece, Galena Lawrence, so we started singing along, and then shared it with the family. So we'd like to share with you the song, One Speed. Ahu.
Thank you.
Cool. This next song we'd like to share with you this morning is called Sacred Bond. It was a wedding song composed for Ben and Rebecca Purser. It's a love song. So this song is for all you lovers out there. May your relationships, may your lives be sacred. Sacred Bond. Ahu.
Oh,
At this time, I'd like to call upon my sister, little singer, Alyssa Old Coyote, Alyssa Naluka Old Coyote, and her awesome husband, Michael Naluka Old Coyote. I'd like to ask them to come out to the floor. Since we're in the mood for love at this time, these guys are newlyweds. And this next song we'd like to share, it's called Walkin' Beauty. This is their song for their day and for their life. And at this time, our dancers are gonna come out there and grab you. And you know the rules. No saying no, you gotta dance. This is a song that was composed for their wedding day. Once we get everybody out there, even if a dancer doesn't grab you, if you feel the need to come out and get this beauty, this good medicine, I encourage you to grab your partner and come out here and dance. If you have been eyeballing somebody all week long, all these last 2 weeks, wherever you started from, this is that time, relatives. Come on out and dance. This is that time. Grab a partner. Walk in beauty. And it's not always like that, you know, it's somebody that you feel real good about, somebody that you love with your heart, somebody that's in your life that makes your life better. It's not always about a love relationship, it's about that good feeling of family. So in that way too, I invite you down to the floor.
Oh.
What a beautiful sight, sacred. What a sacred, beautiful sight to see all these beautiful people out here. Thank you for coming out, dancing with us. This next song we'd like to share is Unity. It's what we feel in our heart. It's what we keep in there. It's what we think about when we sing, when we gather, a united peoples, coming together, powerful, strong, proud, healthy. Being united for our young ones, for those ones that are yet to be born. Because we as a nation, we as Indian people, we as human beings need to get our acts together. And all of you being here, knowing that I know that you guys all have those same thoughts. Of course you want a healthy family. Of course you want your children to be brought up safe. This song is called Unity.
Oh,
Yahoo.
At this time, I'd like to take this opportunity to really let each and every one of you know how happy I am right now. Because my dad, he came up here to be with us during protocol. My dad's the one. There's a long story behind it, but to make a long story short, my dad's the one who set this foundation. Him and another beloved elder that passed away many years ago in Suquamish, a long time ago, before there were canoes there. Or before the canoes came back, before those songs came back. They planted these eggs. They made these bags of prayers, and they planted them all over in the woods in Suquamish, praying for those canoes, praying for those songs, praying for our ancestors to lead us the way in Suquamish. That's where my family lives, in Suquamish. And they did that out of love for those people. My son is enrolled Suquamish, and I have a lot of love for Suquamish. And I'm real happy that they have a whole bunch of canoes now, and they have songs, and they stand proud with each other. Last night they rocked this house. Last night they raised the roof on this house. The spirits, our ancestors, were happy. And I just wanted to recognize my dad, Steve Old Coyote, and one of our beloved elders that's looking down and smiling on us right now. So I want to pass this mic over to him and give him a chance to express himself to you guys, to your family. Ahoo, this is my dad.
Kids here, my grandkids. Some people know me as the greatest lover of all times. Oh, Rabona, I hope this chair holds me up. When these old guys get up here, we start talking about the good old days. I'll give you some advice. You better run like hell, because this is the biggest illegal gathering I've ever seen. And we used to get arrested for doing this. Ramona remembers those days. And all them things happened. But I'd like to talk a little minute about the women, who are the core and the background of this, the backbone. My great-grandma came from Canada, down into southern Minnesota, in the late 1800s, because we wouldn't sign. My Cree people up there in their band wouldn't sign the peace treaty. So they was put on the hanging list. And she was 17 years old. And she walked over 700 miles and got into southern Minnesota, where she married, settled down, had my grandpa and my mom and on down the line. And if it wasn't for her great sacrifice, none of this would be here today. None of us would. And so remember those old grannies. They are the power. 1963, I pulled into a place called Berkeley, California, sitting on a bench in front of a place called the Pub. And some people were getting ready to raise hell about something. And we were sitting there, me and two other guys I met there, from Oklahoma, and watching them and everything. And the guy come over and he says, "You know what?" He said, "I don't understand." He says, "You Indians got screwed around the most, and yet you sit around and you don't say nothing." But you know, we never had a voice, so we didn't know how to say nothing. We didn't know who to say it to. We were totally separated from that part of the world. But then as years went by, we started standing up for each other, standing up for the people. We learned how to talk their language, and we learned how. And we fought hard, and we made it. Some of us got beat up pretty bad. I was nearly beat to death twice. I know that I did a lot of time. I went to prison behind all this. In prison, they locked us up because we wanted to have the sacred feathers and pipes. And so they were already in jail, so they locked us up even some more. And I got to thinking about it when I was sitting in lockup down there in the hole. And I was sitting there all naked in that square cement box in the dark, and I was just thinking, how did this happen to me? How did this happen to me? And I did it because I was going at it the wrong way. And an old man named Phil Lane came in, and he talked to us about it. And he said, follow your ways, follow your traditions. Use your ways, your feathers, your pipes, your rattles, your drums. Use those and follow those. They will lead you on a good fight, and you won't have to deal with any of this anymore. And so we started doing that. I started going everywhere where there was a gathering, wherever there was a prayer, wherever there was a ceremony. And I kept doing that. And it did lead me this. It led me to right where I am right now, the most beautiful time of my life. I say thank you to my grandma, Jenny, they called her, but her name was Abigail. But I give thanks to her and her memory, to my grandma and grandpa, and to my son, my daughters, for keeping me going that way. I've been sober for 36 years. And I don't think that's really a great thing because we're supposed to be sober. That's the way we're supposed to be. And the other thing is, too, is my wife would kick me out if I was drinking. So I'd like to, at this time, call her up here. Rita, I'm going to put you on the spot. That means I'll be cooking my own dinner tonight. But she gave me the ability with my children to love and be loved. I never knew what that was, but she taught me that. She showed me that by her love and her strength. And why we are here today as strong and healthy as we are is because of her guidance. And I owe her that greatest gratitude. I wish there was some way I could put it into words. I would say love and all that, but those words just aren't big enough for what this woman represents.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Rita, and Stephen and I have been married for 36 years. That's how long he's been sober. So, yep, I didn't put up with it. But all I want to say is that, you know, we stand here with the memory of our ancestors. You know, my children, my mother, I think of my mother, I think of my grandfather Tomokto. That's the name that my children carry, my sons and my grandson, my son and my grandson. And my grandfather was a canoe carver up in BC. He died when he was 93. I saw in the Olympics the other day that they were bragging about this man who ran the fastest mile, a 4-minute mile, and he was the first one in the world. He was not the first one in the world. My grandfather was the first one in the world who ran that 4-minute mile, and nobody recognized that because he was Indian. So I want to put my hands up to my grandfather. My grandfather, my family up there gave us this foundation. I was out on the Fraser River with him. I fished, I dried fish on the banks of the Fraser River. And if anybody's ever seen that Fraser River, it's pretty treacherous. I lost many cousins in that river. fishing, and we would go out in the canoe, and it would, you know, it was nothing to us. We had no fear, but that's a real treacherous river. But that's our foundation, you know, that's where my family comes from. And I look at them and I just love them because the blood that flowed in my grandfather's veins, my mother's veins, my ancestors' veins, flows in mine and it flows in the veins of my children. And that I love because we're strong and we go forward with this strength and we look to the future. Our little ones dancing out here, there's nothing more important than that, our babies. And someday they're going to be grandparents and their children, you know, are going to look at us and, you know, look back and see our history. And this is what it's all about. We are making history. And this is the gift that we give to our children. This is the gift that our ancestors gave to us, was this, being able to do this. They gave their lives in residential schools, and they kept this alive somewhere in there. They kept it alive so that we can do this today. I would like to recognize, in our group we have Hawaiians, and I love our Hawaiian members. We are all nations, and I want you to know that they're included with us because they're in the same battle that we're in here in the Hawaiian Islands. But I would like you to know that we do love you. We respect each and every one of you. We love you, and thank you.
In closing, I'd like to say for us to always remember the beauty of our traditions, the beauty of this land, the beauty that's in that water that you paddle on, the beauty of us, Native people. Thank you.
The next song we'd like to share, it's called Double Coastal. Comes from our brother here, Big Steve, Port Gamble, Skalalam. It's a blessing song. Enjoy. Ahu. Thank you.
next song that I would like to share with you, Coastal Flow, composed by myself. This song came to me over a year ago, and I was walking through the woods one night, and I was just walking, and all of a sudden I just heard this song in the wind, and I caught it, and I started singing it, and this is what came out. The song is called Coastal Flow.
There's a feeling when you're out there paddling in your canoe, just cruising right along, and that canoe starts to pick up, starts to get light. You don't even feel like you're pulling. It doesn't even feel like there's any pressure, and that wind is blowing in your face.
that spirit is alive. There's that connection between the pullers and that relative that's carrying you. Travel into that next destination. You're just feeling good, man. You're just pulling right along. And that's what this next song is all about. It's called Groovin'. This next song we'd like to share is a challenge song. Nowadays, you know, we have the dance-offs, the step-up movies, you know, your best moves. Well, this is our coastal version of those. It's the challenge. Our dancers here would like to put that challenge out to whoever is out there that wants to come down and shake your tail feathers. So come on down and take this challenge. It's a feel-good song. Come down and dance your heart out. Come down and dance for your ancestors. The challenge song. Aho relatives, hold my hands up to you dancers, thanking you for coming out, honoring us with your strong spirits, your good dance moves. Aho, at this time, kind of a special little time here. We had the opportunity to stand up with West Shore yesterday and our relatives from Lummi. And one of their songs, They spoke of a strong young lady, strong woman, who stands up for her country. And I was real happy to look across our circle and see that Katrina showed up. Katrina Rodriguez, I'd like to ask you to come out to the floor. This next song we'd like to share is Holding Up the Warriors. It's our tribute to our veterans. It's our tribute to those ones that shed that blood and those tears for each and every one of you. So calling all our veterans to come down to the floor and let us hold you up today. And join my sister here, Katrina. She pulled with us this year, and I'm real proud to say that you're a part of our family that way. You make us that much stronger with your spirit and with the person that you are and your family, West Shore. I'm real thankful. So asking our veterans to come down to the floor. Let us hold you up today. Let us honor you the best way that we know how. Just line up right here. Just make a line right here. This song was composed for the Suquamish Warrior Society. They asked our family to make this song for them so that they can come into the powwows, you know, when they carry those colors, when they carry and represent the branch that they fought in. And if you guys can turn around and face that way, that'd be awesome. And Katrina, can you please join these guys? All veterans, please come down. Like I said, let us hold you up today, holding up the warriors. Much love, much respect for each and every one of you. Thanking you today for what you've done for this country and for what you've done for our families. Ahu. So once again, with love and respect, we hold you up, we hold each and every one of you up. We ask the Creator to bless your families, those ones that couldn't be here, those ones that couldn't make it home. We have them in our hearts, we have them in our minds, our brothers and sisters. So, thanking each and every one of you. Thank you for blessing us, coming out here, standing, letting our girls dance around like that. So, everybody can sit down. And at this time, love you guys. This next song we'd like to share is the victory song. It's victorious that we're all here together. It's victorious that our children are here, that they're not out there. I feel strong and I feel proud to be able to be here, share this time, the victory song.
Oh,
This next song we're going to share with you is to express how honored we feel to be here with you guys today. You know, you guys have been an excellent host, and we feel honored that all of you guys are here with us this morning, giving us your time and patience. So this next song we're going to share with you is the honor song, composed by myself, Sammy Mabe. Aichikasim. Oh. Everyone having a good time? This next song we're gonna share with you is a song that came to me after, just a little bit after last year's journey to Swin. When we got home, you know, I was feeling good and everything, and then I hit a little, just a little rough patch. Nothing too deep, but enough to make me feel a little down inside. And I was praying about it, and this song came to me, and we call it New Beginnings, because every now and again, we just need to, you know, have a fresh start and clean that slate on the inside. And that's what this song represents. Haichikasim.
Oh,
This next song we'd like to share is Love for the People. Love for the People.
Oh.
We just have one more song before we paddle out. It's our thank you song. Many hajkas. Comes from the old Cowdy family, comes from sacred water. Many hajkas. We hold up the host. We thank you. And before we paddle out, we do have a giveaway. We have a few gifts that we'd like to honor your people with, honor your elders with, and your youth with. So we're going to sing the song, Many Hajkas.
Oh.
Sam. We will now begin to get our giveaway stuff together. I'm up here trying to burn a little mic time while they do that, Sam. And our elder Steve Olkayo has. Oh, sorry, hold on. So at this time, I'm going to turn the mic over to Steve Olkayot while we get our giveaway stuff together. He's got a presentation he needs to take care of. He's got a little work he needs to do. So Steve Olkayot, Archka Sam.
I'd like to call Tiwani Sami. Tiwani, you come up here and come up with me, babe. All the things that I talked about going through to get where we are today, this young man has gone through the same thing. He's been knocked down, beat up, drug out, locked up, and treated like a dog. But he came out of that singing. He came out of that praying. And when I stood up with my brothers, the veterans here, I stood up there representing the Native American movement, what I've been a part of all my life, and so is he. And in that way, Tiwani, you have shown me the greatest respect, the greatest love, and I know that our future generations are going to be in better shape because of men like you. I've carried this old drum for a lot of years. I buried my mom, my dad, my sister, my brother-in-law, a lot of people, a lot of ceremonies. And at this time, in respect to your service to the people, I would like to pass this drum on to you. And from today forth, and I love you and respect you, and I look at you as my son.
RCM. RCM Nisiaya, CM Nisquoma, Dimatho Teltel Squeeds, Talitzo Kwa Stalo, Squa. My name is Dimatho Tel. I come from Squa, Chilliwack, from the Stalo people. My auntie that was up here earlier, her grandfather and my great-grandfather were brothers, Tastasalak and Hamatal. We come from Squay and Squa and Chilliwack. And this family does have a lot of different people that sit with the and sing that have come together. It's very moving to watch everything that happens throughout this journey. And we were sitting across yesterday when a chlami were on the floor. And we have a lot of young children that follow this group, a lot of young people that sit back and watch everything that's going on. And they remember, even when they're playing and it seems like they're not paying attention and they're not listening to you, they're listening. But I was really moved yesterday when the West Shore family sang one of their songs, their Eagle song. This floor here was filled with young girls, young ladies. But one of the things that moved me very much was there was elder ladies from Tlemi that also went out there and danced, and they were smiling and they were enjoying themselves. And that was touching. And I have a small gift that I'd like to ask Sadie and Ludi. I'd like to just thank you for showing our young children, especially our young ladies and our young men, that you're not too old to be on this floor. We can't be backwards about coming out here and sharing our dances and songs with the people. And this goes for all of the children that are watching. Our grandmothers were dancing, and they were proud, and they were having fun. And I'd like to ask if you could come forward, if somebody can come forward for Auntie Ludi as well. I have this little gift, and it would be an honor if you wore this on your hats. And I'd like to really applaud these elder ladies for doing this. And it's something that we all have to remember and thank them, especially for going out there and enjoying themselves. And thank you. I really thank you on behalf of myself and my children and my family. My younger sisters are going to come forward, and we'd like to, thank you. I only wanted to take a little bit of that time. I just only felt it was right. This big giant 12-year-old here is my son. But he, on this journey here, he's taken steps along with my family in the work that he's doing, and it's something I've been trying to push him to do for the past few years. But I really want to thank my brothers and sisters for allowing me to do this, and thank our aunties especially for the beauty that they're carrying, and acknowledge that.
So at this time, we got a little work we need to take care of here. We'd like to, we have a few giveaway items for our host to show our gratitude and appreciation for the stay here, Never have I been on journeys where we had such plush, shag, carpet-like grass up in a field before. That is just, I personally have a cot, but I didn't need it if I wouldn't have brought, I could have done without that this year. So that was just, the campgrounds are just great, and the people here are great, and the food's great. So we wanna honor you with a couple humble tokens from the family. If we can get a male and female elder to come up, please. Can we also get male and female youth to come up? And you know, these, if you haven't noticed, we got a lot of youth rolling with our family. And I remember when I was a young man in Suquamish, you know, James touched on this earlier, we didn't really have canoes. We had lost a lot of that. And so to see all these young ones out here and to see all the young ones from Squaxin Island, you know, we just want to hold our hands up to you and give you guys a small token of our appreciation as well. Hachka Sam. This next person we'd like to stand up, you know, he's real important to our family as well as to myself. For those of you that don't know, I'm a few years into recovery, and when I checked into Northwest Indian Treatment Center a few years ago, which is a Squaxin ran facility, This guy came and sweated with me, you know. He's always been there and stood with our family and has always backed us and treated us very kindly. So, Skolas, would you mind coming up here and accepting a token of our appreciation, too? Or Gina, so get it close. This next person we'd like to stand up, can we go ahead and get George Christ up here, please? We'd like to honor a skipper of the Squaxin people. This year we had a couple new members join our canoe family, and this is one of them. He's a Port Gamble Skalalum. His name is George Sparks, and he puts in a lot of work for this family, and he would like to gift you this paddle on behalf of us. Last but not least, can we get a representative of the cooks, please? Some of you guys might have been out on that final protocol landing down there when we were getting accepted in Olympia. And You know, we sat out there in that baking sun for quite a few hours, you know, and when we got to shore, we were real hungry, got on a bus, came up here, and had one of the best cups of clam chowder I ever had in my life. So I actually had about four of them. I might have went through the line a few times. But so if we could get a representative of the cooks, because we really have been fed just tremendously while we were here, and we really appreciate it. So at this time, we also would like to honor the rest of our council over here. We're going to have some kids bring you guys a couple tokens of our appreciation just to show our respect and let you know we're really grateful for being here. So if you guys could please stand so they can spot you, and you kids go help them out. So we're going to have the kids come around and pass out a few of the tokens we have left here to the council, and then we're going to paddle on out of here. But on behalf of Sacred Water Canoe family, we'd like to thank all of you for your time and patience. We love the fact that you guys come and watch us and come and give us that respect. It makes us feel good inside. And we hope at some point we made you guys feel good too, you know? So on behalf of our family, I hold my hands up to you guys. We hold our hands up to you guys for everything. And at this time, I would like to ask the Squaxin Island, we are planning on staying until the end, but we would humbly request permission to untie our canoe and leave your shores. So this last song we're going to share with you is a song we share with the Muckleshoot Canoe family, and it's called the Eagle Spirit Paddle Song. Hachkasim.